It's VanGuard98, and this is take two of this episode, because last time I played this episode, my computer restarted. Yay! So, we're going to go episode two now, or part five of the movie series, I guess. Get Tannen. So, alright. Here we go. New game. Yes, so goals. Last time. Marty was fading away from existence. So, Saturday, June 13th, 1931. Yeah, Marty was fading, and 'cause once again, he messed up his timeline. Silly Marty. Alright, so let's get dangerous. Bob Gill. Yep, there he goes.
What's happening?
I don't know. Unless tomorrow's newspaper. Do you still have it?
Yeah. Local accountant beaten. Left for dead.
Local accountant Arthur McFly was severely beaten and left for dead on the steps of the Hill Valley Courthouse last night.
They're gonna kill my grandpa?
Tannen's goons, no doubt. Probably in retaliation for Arthur answering that subpoena you delivered.
What are we gonna do?
I'm not sure what we can do. According to this, your grandfather was dumped on the doorsteps of the courthouse 5 minutes ago.
My dad's picture is disappearing.
That's the time stream catching up with your grandfather's fatal wounds. Which means your father will never be born, and neither will you, unless...
Back in time again.
When did you last see your grandfather?
4 o'clock, in the town square.
Let's give him enough time to make his deposition.
Right.
We'll have to be careful not to run into ourselves.
That shouldn't be a problem in your case. I mean, you were in jail.
All right, let's get moving before the police find us.
Freeze!
I found you.
Step out of the car with your hands up.
Side.
What was that?
What was what?
Crap! I heard something back there.
I think you're mistaken.
Gonna play a ring around the rosy.
Well, looks like I caught me a fugitive. Carl Sagan, the speakeasy arsonist.
Alleged speakeasy arsonist, if you don't mind.
What the heck kind of buggy is that?
Stay back. It's a prototype, still untested, liable to blow up at any moment. Or suddenly take off without warning.
That's so. There it is again.
I think the night air is playing tricks on you, officer.
What is it? Some kind of foreign job? A German or something?
Not at all. This is solid American workmanship.
Now I'm sure something's back there.
But it was back here before. The cat.
Looks like something out of Buck Rogers.
A year from now, everybody will be driving these babies.
I wouldn't be surprised if there's a promotion in this. You're getting to be a valuable commodity in Hill Valley.
Huh. That's very gratifying to hear.
I hope you don't mind cooling off a few minutes till reinforcements get here.
I don't mind, but the car may have other ideas.
What was that?
What was what?
Crap! I heard something back there.
I think you're mistaken.
Stop hearing things. Ugh, this iPad was... proud guy for this,
to get
but...
a closer look at that getaway car.
What's that? Off in those bushes.
Huh? I didn't hear anything.
I thought it was my henchman returning, but you're probably right. It was nothing.
Henchman, you say? There it is again.
I think the night air is playing tricks on you, officer.
What was that?
I didn't hear anything.
Now I'm sure something's back there.
Right from the car, and you don't see me at all, because... wow.
Hey! Stop!
Doc! No!
Save your grandfather! I'll be fine until you get back.
You got it, Doc.
What was that?
.455. Artie's gotta be in there somewhere, spilling his guts to the DA.
This is where my computer restarted last time, so hopefully this time...
all I gotta do is get to him before...
it won't.
Mr. Crockett!
Oh, look. It's you again.
I was wondering if I could do a little follow-up interview with you about the plight of poor Mr. Sagan. My sources indicate that Judge Brown will be setting him free tomorrow.
I wouldn't bet on that.
What's that?
Nothing. Listen, can we talk later? I've really gotta get to the courthouse right now.
Really? Why?
My grandpa needs me as a character witness to get a fishing license.
Oh, well then, carry on. And do put that vicious dog of yours on a leash, will you? We have laws about that sort of thing, you know.
Sure, no problem.
Yeah. I'm thinking of the dog. Here's Einstein.
Oh, come on, yesterday, Marty. Stop talking. Get moving. Einstein, what is it, boy?
Stay,
boy.
Crap. Silly dog.
Einstein. Is it a squirrel, Einie?
Alright. Get the stick.
You wanna play? Okay, let's play. What are you up to, Einie? Go get her, Einie! You!
Oh! Get this mangy animal away from me!
Oh, come on, Einstein. Get away from the nice lady.
My shoes!
Einstein, no!
No!
Way to go, Einie. Now, to get into that courthouse and grab Artie before Tannen's guys.
Uh-oh. They saw him!
Hey.
Oh, God. Hey.
According to my calculations, the rotary engine for a full-scale rocket drill requires 1.21 kilowatts of power. Can you check over my work to make sure? Are you all right?
Yeah. But I need to get to Arthur.
Why?
He might be headed for an accident.
Arthur McFly may not be the most coordinated fellow around, but I'm sure he can walk up a flight of stairs. Come on, shouldn't we be getting on with our work? We're on a strict deadline, right?
Uh,
Sure. You start without me. Turn around and start walking, and I'll catch up to you in just a few minutes.
Huh?
Oh, hell. Oh, my God! What the hell is that?
What's what?
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to you.
No, I mean before, while I was walking towards you.
I wasn't talking to anyone. I was working on equations for my rocket drill.
No, I mean after. Never mind. Let's get going.
Follow me.
Okay.
I thought I'd never leave. At least now I have a clear shot to the courthouse. You gotta come with me. Look, you're in a lot of danger.
What do you mean I'm in danger?
No time to explain, Grand Marty. Just promise me you'll stay at the police station until...
Marty McFly. Just the guy we're looking for.
Hey, fellas.
Run!
Get him!
Bonk. Uh-oh.
Artie? I better pick up their trail before I start fading out again. Keys to the DeLorean.
Oh, yeah, that's right, running. Running, 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 running.
Looks clear.
All right, McFly. Let's go see the boss.
How's my favorite accountant doing?
Oh, I've been better. Oh,
I'm so sorry to hear that, McFly. Trixie, take a powder, doll. We got business to discuss.
K.O., you boys play nice now. Mwah! Nice to see you again, Artie.
You too, Miss Trotter.
Oh, yeah, we're all happy as clams. Now scram! You guys stupid? What are you thinking, bringing this fish food to my doorstep?
We just thought...
That was your first mistake. Thinking. Look at me. Do you ever catch me thinking?
Huh? No.
Don't answer that. Look, just drag him inside, find out what he told the DA, then get rid of him.
I think we can handle that.
Good. Now, if you don't mind, I've got an arsonist to snuff out. And will one of you slobs start hauling these crates in?
We're on it, kid.
So far, so good.
Huh. Nope, still fading.
I better get in there quick. Contents. One winged goddess. Oops.
I'm an artist. Get in the crate.
Nice fit. Here goes nothing.
Prince cue ball. Stir the soup cue ball. Clean out the bloodstains cue ball. Shit. I'm not a gangster, I'm a freaking butler. Now which one of you guys goes in first?
Jeez, for a gal with no arms, you sure is heavy.
I can do this. This is gonna be tricky.
Whoops.
Ow. Do you mind? I'm trying to conduct a professional interrogation over here.
Where should I put this?
Just shove it behind the bar.
I'll just shove you behind the bar.
Come on, Artie. Jeez, how much chloroform did you put on that rag anyway?
What?
Because I'm having a hard time bringing Sleeping Beauty here around.
Let me see. Hey, Artie! We got a few questions about you and the DA.
D-A-D-E-D?
You see what I'm working with here?
Seems to be catching.
Zane, wake up!
Oh, sorry, boss. The stupid cold's got me wiped out.
Well, try to stay awake long enough to finish that poster, will ya? We got a club to open in a few days. And turn off that sign, would ya? Wake up, sleepyhead.
Alright. Let's see if I can do this.
I hope the Sisters of Mercy approve of our redecorating.
What do I spy with my little eye? Word games?
Okay, bang button, lower form, counter.
Ugh, stupid cold.
Alright. I can't find it. Oh well.
No wonder Artie's so out of it.
This is gonna be the swellest speakeasy in Hill Valley.
It's gonna be the only speakeasy in Hill Valley.
Oh, right. Funny how the competition is sort of...
Oh, hey, guys. I don't feel so...
Zane! Wake up, you lazy bum!
Must have been the cold.
Cold my eye. He's been dipping into the inventory.
The inventory? One more on down. Two to go.
Think there's a way we could get Rip Van Winkle here talking in his sleep?
Yeah, I sleep-talked once. That's how I ended up married to Mildred.
Remind me to sleep-slap you later tonight.
The only thing I want to break this bottle on is one of those goons' heads. Ow! I...
What the?
I think we blew a fuse.
Well, go up to the soup kitchen and get a new one.
Why me?
You'd rather hang around and talk to this guy, huh?
3 days are here again.
Yeah, I'll just get that fuse.
See if you can do this.
Come on, Artie, wake up. You're sleeping your life away. Literally.
for the bottle.
You're trying my patience, Artie. Wake up, sleepyhead.
McDermott's Canadian whiskey.
Get me out of here!
Damn it. Oh.
Wake up, sleepyhead.
Didn't make it fast enough. Didn't get that trophy.
Again?
Must have been a faulty fuse.
Well, go get one that ain't so faulty.
You know, some people know how to say please every now and then.
Damn. Oh, well.
Come on, Artie. Wake up. You're sleeping your life away. Literally.
Here we go.
Bam! Right in the kisser.
Made it.
Hey, you. Wait, do I know you? Not for about 40 years.
Is anyone down there?
Everything's spinning. Come on, Artie. Let's get out of here before these jerks get a chance to kill you.
Wait a minute. They were gonna kill me?
Yep. Great.
This isn't funny, guys. Is anyone down there?
Damn it.
Perfect timing. Hang on, Grandpa. We've got a pickup to make. Need a lift?
I thought you'd never ask. Ah, what's he doing here?
It's a long story.
It had to save his life.
Oh, son of a...
And then I carried Artie to the DeLorean and came back to get you.
Fascinating.
So we can go home now, right?
Not yet. We still have this loose end to tie up.
No, don't tie me up again.
He's coming around.
So please be careful. You won't be safe in Hill Valley as long as Kit Tannen remains at large.
Don't worry, I'm going far away from Hill Valley, and I'm never coming back.
No! He's got to hook up with Grandma.
What's her name?
It's Sylvia.
You know a woman named Sylvia?
No.
Well, she knows you. We'll know you. It's vitally important that you two meet.
Oh, I get it. You want me to be part of some undercover sting operation.
No, possibly.
Yeah. Are you G-Man?
Uh-huh.
Something like that.
Sure, anything for Uncle Sam. I'll stay nearby and wait for this Sylvia. But in the meantime, I'll lay low.
Good man.
When can I expect to see you again?
That was a close call.
You think he'll be okay?
You're not fainting out, are you? Besides, Arthur will be completely out of danger come August 25th.
August 25th?
That's the date Kit Tannen is finally put behind bars. How's that picture of your dad?
Still there.
Good. Let's get out of here before we accidentally elect Hoover to a second term.
Here we go. Back to the future for the first time in this game.
Well, everything looks okay.
Are you sure?
See, McFly residence. So, wanna come in? Maybe hang out a while? I want my dad to see for himself that you're still around.
I'd love to, Marty, but...
You've gotta go. I understand, Doc. You've got a life to lead, and the kids to raise and all that.
No, I've gotta go to the bank and stop that estate sale you told me about.
Oh.
You go find your pop. I'll be back within the hour.
See you soon, Doc.
Gotcha.
Alright. Hey, anyone home? There's something wrong with my key.
Please, not now. Tomorrow. Give me another day.
Another day? Dad, what are you talking about?
Marty. No, that's impossible. Marty was run out of town.
I've got a bad feeling about this. What are you talking about? What's the matter, Dad? Are you in trouble or something?
This is a trick. Go away.
Leave us alone. Haven't we suffered enough?
Mom. Get Dave and Linda.
They left town years ago, which you would know if you really were a Marty.
How can I convince you?
Tell me something only Marty would know.
When I was eight years old, I set fire to the living room rug.
That's right.
Oh, my Lord. What are you waiting for, George? Let him in.
Stupid locks. Marty!
Oh, my God, Dad. What happened to you?
What do you think happened, butthead?
Biff.
I thought we told you to stay out of town, shrimp.
Whatever's going on, I'm sure we can handle it. Reasonably. Who are they?
Yeah, like you don't know Cliff and Riff.
What do you think we should do with them, baby bro? What we should have done years ago, big bro.
Oh, I'm gonna enjoy this, McFly.
Wait, I'm trying to process here. What the hell did you do to my dad?
Your dad's been in that wheelchair since before you were born, butthead.
And you better hope he has a spare, because you're going to need one in like 3 seconds.
I got a question. When did I get run out of town?
2 years ago. Don't you remember? We made a deal that we'd go easier on your old man if you left.
But now you're back, so the kid gloves can come off.
Ooh. Hey!
And another thing. Why are you guys so pissed at me?
You don't remember? You've really lost it, McFly.
Think back. The thing with the manure truck?
Which one? Tell me. What about my mom? I mean, how did she end up with my dad?
Beats us. Guess she has a thing for losers. She could have had any one of us, but she went for old Gimpy McFly.
Here's what I still don't understand. How long have you been coming down on my dad like this?
Ever since that school dance, when Georgie laid Biff out in the parking lot.
Shut up, it's not funny.
Someone messes with the Tannen family never lets him forget about it.
Biff! Wait, does all this have something to do with Kid Tannen?
Pop? What about...
He was supposed to end up in jail.
Jail? Pop's never spent a day in jail in his life.
The Tannen Gang's the fifth most dangerous crime family in California. We got connections all over the place.
No way.
You don't believe me?
Beth, no!
Bang! Check it out.
To your family from mine, in gratitude for your continued service, J.J. Valenti.
That's Don Valenti, godfather of the Sacramento mob.
The third most dangerous crime family in California.
Piece of cake.
I never should have let that floozy talk me out of rubbing out your grandfather.
Huh? Kid?
No one in Hill Valley messes with the Tannen family.
Doc!
Marty, get in. This timeline's been compromised.
No kidding.
Somehow, something we did in 1931 allowed Kid Tannen to escape his date with justice. As a consequence, the Tannens have been unchecked in Hill Valley for over 50 years.
Ah, jeez, they robbed the arcade.
We've got to go back to the day Kid Tannen was supposed to be arrested. Figure out what went wrong and fix it. Otherwise, you could be forever stuck in a town owned by the Tannens.
Not an option, Doc. Punch it.
Find the flop house. Well, I got the trophy.
Okay, Doc. Let's run through this again.
Sometime tonight, Kid Tannen is supposed to be betrayed by his mole, a singer named Trixie Trotter.
That hot babe I saw coming out of the speakeasy.
Exactly. When she does, history says Tannen will be arrested by a rookie cop by the name of Danny Parker.
Parker. Hey, do you think he's related to Jennifer Parker, my girlfriend?
Could be.
Heavy.
In any event, somehow we've changed history so that neither of these events happens, condemning your family to generations of abuse at the hands of a Tannen crime family. You need to go back into Tannen's speakeasy, find out what's gone wrong, and get Kid Tannen arrested.
No problem, Doc. Let me just put on my hat and I'm good to go. Is the mustache really necessary?
It's essential. You can't let Kid know that you're the same troublemaker that foiled his attempt to kill me.
You sure you can't come in with me?
It's far too dangerous. You may be easy to disguise with your nondescript features, but ever since my daring escape from the police and the mob, my distinctive face has been plastered over every paper from here to Reno.
Nondescript?
I'll find a safe place to hunker down. That flop house ought to fit the bill. You can find me there if you need me.
Pardon me, sir. From the way you're dressed and your general aura of seediness, I can infer only one thing. You're heading for Tannen's speakeasy. Am I right?
Yeah. Can't you tell me the way?
Down. Straight down. The last stop before the inferno. Unfortunately, I don't have the power to stop you, but I beg you to tarry here a few more seconds and listen to my song. Me, 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 me. In heaven's name!
Oh, sorry, Miss Strickland. Just a little experimental prototype gone momentarily awry.
Mr. Brown, why is there a dog in that vehicle?
Why? Well, to advance the human condition, of course. Hello, Sonny.
Sonny? Mr. Crockett, what are you doing in that getup?
I'm going undercover.
How exciting! You'll have to give me an exclusive sometime. Right now, I've got some souls to save.
And you'll have to get an eyeful of my newest experiment.
You're not angry about the rocket drill?
Water over the bridge. I've moved on to bigger and better things. Come by the gazebo when you get a chance. I'll be setting up. You won't believe what Einie and I have been up to.
Famous last words. All right. Now, where's that speakeasy?
Here we go.
Who sent you?
Ulysses S. Grant.
What did you bring me?
Meat and potatoes.
What's the word?
Words are for wimps.
Who told you to come here?
Hieronymus Bosch?
What will you do when I send you away?
Radio for help?
Take a hike, squirt.
Damn it. Oh, that's...
Who gave you the right to knock on my door?
What? Ah,
war is dead.
Damn it.
What will you do if there's a raid?
Wait till Wednesday?
Who is the king of Siam?
Am I?
What will you do tomorrow?
Row my boat?
Where you born?
Borneo.
Welcome to L Kids.
Missed that one too. Or not. Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to once again present the hottest little number this side of the Rockies. And when I say my pleasure, I think y'all know what I'm talking about. Am I right? So let's have a big L Kid welcome for the one, the only, Trixie Trotter.
They say I'm crazy, got no sense, but I don't care. They may or may not mean offense, but I don't care.
Out of my way, kid. I got some sorrows to drown.
You in?
Why not?
I don't care.
Double zero.
Ugh, can't get that one. Yes, can't find that thing.
Two.
Ugh.
the shrew. Didn't burrow deep enough. Checkerboard Charlie, removed from the board. I guess someone jumped him. Looks like someone's about to be added to Tannen's Wall of Fame. Louis the Louse, squashed in his prime. Bucktooth Langley, bit off more than he could chew. Chuckles Lenart, he didn't get the last laugh. Hey, bartender.
What'll it be?
So about this, portrait gallery of yours.
What about it?
What's it all about? Who are those guys?
The caricatures hanging along the Wall of Honor commemorate those who are no longer with us on account of having ticked off one Irving Kid Tannen.
They're the guys the kids killed?
Well, of course not. They're just a bunch of guys that Kid didn't particularly like and that at a later date turned up dead. It's a circumstantial coincidence. Yeah.
So is your cold all better?
My cold?
Yeah, when I saw you a few hours ago, you were sneezing like crazy.
Mister, I ain't had a cold in over 2 months.
Oh yeah, right. Sorry. Wrong guy. What are you drawing?
Another celebrity caricature.
You drew those?
Prohibition ain't gonna last forever, bub. I gotta have a skill I can fall back on when all this goes away.
Think you could do a caricature of me?
Sure. Presto!
That really doesn't look like me.
I didn't have much to work with.
Who are you working on now?
Boris Karloff. What do you think?
Not bad. What can you tell me about Trixie?
You trying to put the moves on Kid's dame?
No way.
Good, because if you did, I'd probably be hanging you on the Wall of Honor. Know what I mean?
Thanks for the talk.
Next time, order a drink. This ain't no library, you know.
I always wanted to be famous. A pretty bunch. In gratitude for your continued service, J.J. Valenti. You know, a cigarette lighter shaped like a gun seems like a really bad idea.
Hey.
Back off, kid. I'm trying to entertain some people here.
I don't care. It's the lyrics to her song.
Where is the music?
Excuse me, are you Trixie Trotter?
That's what it says on my dressing room door. At least, it would if I had a dressing room.
What's a nice gal like you doing with a guy like Tannen?
Kid ain't so bad. He just takes some...
Hey, Toots, any chance you could sing that can-can number? The guys really love the way it shows off your, assets.
Whatever you say, kid.
And quit lazing around. I ain't paying you to yak with the drunks.
You ain't paying me at all, you bum. What were we talking about again?
I really like your voice.
Thanks. You should hear me when I ain't so under the weather.
You're sick?
Oh, yeah. Sore throat. That's why I'm giving Q-Ball so many extended solos tonight.
I kinda wondered about that. Do you know Sister Christian?
I don't do religious tunes.
I don't care. What are those? Are they lyrics for one of your songs?
I haven't memorized them yet.
You were telling me what a great guy Kid is.
Yeah, I guess he is a pretty crummy boyfriend. But until my insurance policy checks out, I guess I'm stuck with him.
Insurance?
Yeah. Look, I may not be the brightest bulb in the marquee, but even I know, you don't break up with a creep like Kid without something to keep him from going all crazy on you.
Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
She's supposed to turn on Kid Tannen tonight? Okay, Doc, if you say so.
Hey.
Back off, kid. I'm trying to entertain some people here.
Way down in Louisiana, down in New Orleans.
Maybe not.
Hey, I do the singing round here.
Where is the music? The sign.
El Kid. I still don't get it.
It's like that El Cid place down in L.A., only it's El Kid.
Ah, okay, I see.
I don't see.
Hey, I know you. You're...
Parker. Oscar Danny Parker. Hill Valley PD. Have we met? You look familiar.
Nah.
Well, stranger, sit down and have a drink on me.
I hear you've been having troubles.
Troubles? Buddy, nobody knows the troubles I've seen.
Want to talk about them?
Do I? Yeah, I do. Listen, it all started when this car...
Every morning, every evening, paint, we got fun. Not much money, oh, but honey, paint, we got fun.
Whoopee!
Yeah, now, about those troubles.
I don't want to wallow in misery. I came here to get happy. Hallelujah!
In the winter, in the summer, don't we have fun?
See you later, Danny.
I'll be here.
I'm supposed to get this guy to arrest Kid Tannen tonight?
The rich get rich and the poor get children. In the meantime, in between time, egg, we got fun.
There it is. Music.
Danny.
You.
I don't care.
So about those troubles.
I'm not really in the mood to talk about him right now. I just want to drink and listen to Trixie.
Could you be drinking so much on duty?
Probably not, but this joint ain't open when I'm off duty.
See you later, Danny.
I'll be here.
Music. Angry song.
What is this feeling that has me in its grip? What has me on the edge and curling my lip? Worse than the blues or the front page news, it's rage. I'm overflowing. I've asked my doctor and psychiatrist too. They tell me that there's not a thing I can do. There's no consoling and there's no controlling this
Danny,
rage.
You.
I'm overflowing with rage. Daytime,
shouldn't you be arresting Tannen?
For what?
Well, for running a speakeasy, for one thing.
Well, I like this speakeasy. So there. It's like, if I arrested him, I'd have to arrest you and me and everyone else in here. And that's just way too much work for one little cop like me.
So about those troubles.
Go away. I'm drinking.
See you later, Danny.
I'll be here.
Song number two. Sad song.
Come to me, my melancholy baby. Cuddle. All your fears are foolish, Betsy, maybe. You know, dear, that I'm in love with you. Every cloud must have a silver lining. Wait until the sun shines through. Kiss away each tear, or else I shall be melancholy too.
Music. Secret song.
Sharing love, they're not meant for blaring love. Whisper in my ear, so no one can hear. Shh. Whisper in my ear.
Got a secret.
Let me read you soft and clear. Don't make it fortissimo, make it pianissimo. Whisper in my ear, so no one can hear. The caress of
And finally, be happy.
Nice suit. Where'd you get it?
Costume shop at the mall. I had it custom made.
Yeah? Quality material. Who are you? Where are you from?
My name's, Sonny Crockett. I'm one of you guys. Don't you recognize me?
No.
Come on. What's the dough?
Spill it or I'll...
Go easy, kid. From the cut of the suit, I'm thinking he might be with the Valenti gang.
Is that so?
Yes?
Prove it. You ain't leaving till you show me some bona fides.
I've got a little something here that might convince you.
Don't even blink.
It's not a real gun. It's not a real gun, I swear. It's a gift from Don Valenti. See?
To your family from mine, in gratitude for your continued service, J.J. Valenti. Looks like little Sonny Crockett here really is with the Sacramento boys. You got stones, Pee-wee. I like that. Have yourself a drink. On the house. Matches. Put down your gun. You look like a moron.
Back. Lamont's House of Ermine. Sleep tight, little Ermines. Lamont's House of Ermine. Sleep tight, little Ermines. Majestic Arms. Transients welcome. Well, they don't get more transient than me and Doc.
Clubhouse door.
Hey, Doc. How's the room?
It's a little cleaner than I would have imagined for a Depression era flophouse. How are your investigations going?
Where'd you park the DeLorean?
I hid it in the DeSoto lot. Nobody's buying cars these days, so it should be safe in there.
Hey, who did burn down Tannen's original speakeasy anyway?
I still don't know. I'd really like to find out before we go home.
I never did get a straight answer about why he came back to 1931 in the first place.
It's personal. When this is over, I'll tell you all about it.
I'm gonna hold you to that, you know. Can you explain all this? I'm confused.
It's very simple. In the original timeline, Timeline A, the speakeasy arsonist was never caught, creating one of Hill Valley's enduring historical mysteries.
Okay.
When I traveled back to 1931, I created Timeline B, in which I was misidentified as the arsonist and subsequently killed by Kit Tannen's goons. Einstein came with me, and somehow he ended up in the DeLorean when its failsafe mechanism triggered, sending it back to 1986.
Which is where I came in.
Precisely. Traveled back to June 14th, 1931, creating Timeline C, a world in which Carl Sagan wasn't rubbed out by Kit Tannen. But Arthur McFly was served with a subpoena.
And shot by Kid Tana's goons.
Yes. So you jump back in time 6 hours, creating Timeline D, saving your grandfather's life, but somehow preventing Kid Tannen from meeting his date with justice.
Which is why the Tannens were so powerful when we jumped back to 86.
Uh-huh. So now we've returned to August of 1931, creating Timeline E, in which, fingers crossed, we'll send Tannen to prison where he belongs. Got it?
Sure.
Good.
One question.
What?
Can you explain all this? I'm confused. Okay, I better get back to fixing history.
Be careful, Marty.
Gotta see her now, I think, if I remember correctly.
Donate to the Clock Tower Fund. What's wrong with the Clock Tower? It's not broken, is it?
Not in the slightest.
Ooh.
It's just painfully drab. I'm raising funds to commission a sculptor to place a couple of handsome ornamental statues on either side of the clock face. Something to inspire the citizens to do their civic duty.
Something like lions?
Or gargoyles. You can't beat a good gargoyle.
What's all this?
These are my pamphlets, laying out in scientific detail the horrors visited upon those who succumb to the temptations of alcohol.
Lost Fortnite?
I am particularly fond of that one. It tells the true life tale of Johnny, who woke up in a pile of his own sick, completely unable to remember the previous 2 weeks of his life.
Heavy.
Actually, the pamphlets are quite light. See?
Hey, Edna.
Mr. Crockett, what can I do for you?
What was that song you were singing earlier?
Do you like it? I wrote it myself. It really gets the toes tapping at the Stay Sober Society meetings. Although I suppose that could be the shakes. Would you like to hear it again?
Sure.
I knew if I waited long enough, somebody would request it. You say you've lost your self-respect, but you should care. It's not too late to redirect and start to care. Don't despise the good and pure. Time to rise up from the sewer. Wash off all that foul manure. Show the world you care. You should care. You should care. What people think of you. Of goals that you could name, reclaiming your good name is what you ought to do. You should care, you should care. If your reputation is in disrepair, it's not going to hurt you to reclaim your virtue, for you should care.
Catchy.
You really think so?
Yeah, it's, got a good hook to it.
One needs a good hook if one is fishing for souls.
Do you think I could have a copy of your You Should Care lyrics? I've, got a club of my own that could really use some inspiring.
Sure. Let me just get a page out of the hymnal. There you are.
Hey, thanks. See ya.
Keep fighting the good fight.
Back to him real fast.
Sonny, you're just in time.
So, thanks for watching Einstein while I've been away.
It's been a pleasure. He's proven to be a surprisingly willing test subject. Almost as if he's been working with me for years.
More like decades. How have you been, Emmett? I know I haven't seen you in a couple of months.
I'm great, and I owe it all to you.
Really?
Yes, that argument I had with my father during our jet drill experiment gave me the incentive to finally quit that dreary court job. I've committed myself full-time to a life of science.
What's the story with the little car and all this equipment?
Einstein and I are conducting a few experiments with this one-quarter scale model to work out a few hitches in my planned demonstration at the Hill Valley Expo in a couple of months.
A radio-controlled car?
No. Well, yes, but it'll be so much more than that. It will amaze the world. Aha! Got it!
Got what?
I'll show you. Ready to go, Einstein? Watch this! When this baby hits 23 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious cow flop.
Einstein!
No!
Get him out of there!
Not to worry. I've got a fail-safe eject mechanism around here someplace. See? Nothing to worry about.
Nothing? I'll go see if I can find something to help. Or someone. Don't worry, Anna. You'll get it right someday.
Oh, I'm not worried about that. Right now, I'm more concerned with Einstein.
Can't you just go into the courthouse to get Einstein?
If I still had my job as a clerk, sure. But lately, a lot of evidence has gone missing, so they've installed new locks. Now the place is sealed up tighter than my dad's wallet.
What went wrong with your rocket car?
I'm not entirely sure. As soon as we get Einstein down, I'm gonna go look for it.
You know anything about Trixie Trotter?
The songbird of the Sierras? The nightingale of the north? The floozy of the foothills? Never heard of her. And I've definitely never snuck into Tannen's speakeasy to listen to her.
Well, I'll go off and see if I can get her.
You do that. I'll stay here and see if I can think of a way to get Einie off that ledge.
Edna!
What?
I got a hot lead for you.
Oh? What is it?
Young scientist strands dog on courthouse roof.
What?
Look over there.
Oh, for goodness sake. Mr. Brown.
Please, Miss Strickland, not now. Can't you see I've got a rather delicate situation on my hands at the moment? My trial run...
Trial run? Public hazard, I call it. And I'm sure my editor will agree. And really,
come here, Einie!
Please, please,
come on, boy. Fire escapes this way.
How can I be a member of...
Looks like I'm gonna need more help.
Well then, if you refuse to give me a statement, I just won't tell your side of the story.
Arr, damned exasperating woman. Okay, Einie, the bad lady's gone. Come on down.
Doctor, help or not, I'm not sure.
Hey, Doc, I could use a little help.
What's the problem?
Why didn't you tell me I'd run into your younger self tonight?
Because I don't remember being out here tonight. Clearly, your interactions with my younger self 2 months ago have slightly altered my personal timeline. I never have the nerve to perform public experiments like he's doing. No matter, those experiments will be forgotten once I've seen Frankenstein.
Frankenstein?
Yes. Right now, my younger self is fiddling around out there with rocket propulsion systems for his demonstration at the expo.
The thing that'll kick off your scientific career.
Exactly. Now, the rockets are a horrible idea, and I'll soon realize that they'll never work. But eventually, I'll wander into that movie theater and see Frankenstein and clear my mind. I've kept the ticket stub from that movie in my wallet ever since. See?
Why?
Because it's during this movie that I'll have the inspiration for my breakthrough at the expo.
It doesn't have anything to do with reanimating the dead, does it?
Not the way you're thinking, no. But during that famous scene when Colin Clive turned the wheel that raised that shrouded figure into the tower and that bolt of lightning struck, well, let's just say more than one brain was reanimated that night.
Emmett's not having much luck getting Einstein off the courthouse.
I'm not surprised. Einie's a smart dog, but heights give him the willies.
What can we do?
I've got it.
What?
Just get my younger self distracted, and I'll handle the rest.
Okay, I better get back to fixing history.
Be careful, Marty.
Try this again, I guess.
Edna!
What?
Hey, I got a hot lead for you.
Oh, what is it?
There's a new angle on the Emmett Brown story.
What is it?
It's even worse than you thought.
Oh, Lord. Mr. Brown! What is it now, Mr. Brown?
I could ask the same question of you, Miss Strickland.
This scientific enterprise of yours represents a clear and present danger to public safety.
You know what represents a clear and present danger to public safety? Your singing voice.
There's no need to get personal, Mr. Brown.
Believe me, I have no intention of getting personal with you.
I'm relieved to hear it. Flying cars, of all the ridiculous juvenile
notions. You mock
notions.
Me, but just imagine a world in which traffic jams and car crashes are a thing of the past.
I might be more inclined to listen to you if your maiden voyage hadn't ended in a crash on one roof and a stranded dog on another.
I'm working on getting him down. Einie, how'd you get down? Clever dog.
Well, fortune favors you tonight, but I warn you to be more careful in the future.
Now, how to get that rocket car back down?
Welcome back, sir.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid? Trixie?
Yeah?
What's this insurance policy all about?
Are you kidding? There's only one person I trust with my secrets. But I ain't seen him in weeks.
You don't mean...
Artie McFly!
Artie McFly.
You know him?
Not as well as I thought.
Before he took a powder, Artie was tutoring me in all sorts of stuff. Etiquette, philosophy, accounting. He's a regular Renaissance man. He even had one of those smart guy professor's pipes, see?
Can I borrow this?
Sure. I've been secretly working on my Get Out of Kid card for weeks now, but Artie's the only one I trust to check my work. You can't be too careful when you're dealing with a maniac like Kid, you know.
Hey, it looks like they've put a new picture on the Wall of Fame.
Oh, jeez, Kid. Who'd you bump off this time? Who's that supposed to be? Mickey Rooney?
I don't think so. Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
Not a pretty bunch. Nah, I don't think so. Don't think it would go there. Grandpa Artie's pipe. You know, I could barely remember Grandpa from when I was a kid, but this smells like him. Heavy. There's only a few people, and maybe an animal or two, who'd be interested in Grandpa's smelly old pipe. But this isn't one of them. You think you could draw a picture of this guy?
Sure. Hey, that looks like that Artie McFly fink.
I never noticed that before. Hey, can you give him a hat like Artie wears? Should I come back for it?
Suit yourself.
Maybe not.
Oh well. I didn't want to end it here. I want to get the whole episode done, but looks like I'm gonna need some stuff to look up. So, I guess. I'll see you next time, and remember, as always, enjoy the randomness. See ya!